Hey everybody, it's me, CyberGore. How are my favorite people doing? I'm a Crusader. I'm just coming in here to Orison. I'm going to pick up my Vulture and we're going to go out and do some salvage. I'm going to give you some tips and tricks how to make money quickly in the Vulture. And once I get down there, we'll begin. Before we do, I want to thank all our subscribers and channel members. If you haven't done so yet, please hit the subscribe button. We're trying to get to 2,500 subscribers this year. We are less than 1,000 away. Well, I'd really appreciate it. I can't do it without your help. Here we are. We're at Orison. All right. I will see you guys when I land over at Cousin Crow's, because that's where we're going to start. My Vulture's already here. I had to come back here and get it. It's the Kraken. Does it look any better? Any different? Wait. Ooh, they put some weathering on it. I don't think that was there before. Okay, well, alright, let's get what we need. So, every major spaceport, so the planetary spaceports and the orbital space stations of the planets all sell the trawlers. I don't think they sell them anywhere else. If they do, they would be probably at a Platinum Bay in the Lagrange Point space stations. But so they're right here. You want two of them? It's 3,300 credits. I already have two of them, so I'm not gonna buy them. But this is what you'd buy. You'd buy two because you need two for the Vulture. And then once you buy them, go into your vehicle loadout manager. Select your Vulture. And then right here in utility, in sub item slot number 1 and 3, it would say cinch, but I've already removed my cinches and had the trawler on before. You would just replace them with the trawler and then hit save and equip. If you want to upgrade your shields and systems, you could buy those actually right here for the Vulture. I think I'm good. I haven't had any overheating problems or anything, so I'm just gonna leave those coolers there. Actually, those are the best coolers you can get. So yeah, I've already upgraded this ship. I much prefer a faster drive than the Atlas, but the Atlas gets me across the system if I need it and back. So the mighty Vulture, here we go. Let's get aboard. I like to make sure my ship is completely empty of cargo before I leave, and I mean like nothing aboard, especially in the hopper. You can see my hopper is completely empty. Doesn't even have any residual stuff left in from going out and doing scraping for the last couple days. You know why? Because when I go out scraping, I only put one type of cargo in there at a time. So if I'm getting construction materials, that's all I'm going to pull. I'm going to pull 13 SKU of construction material. I'm going to empty it and it's going to be on empty again. Or if I'm pulling recycled composite materials, it's going to be nothing but recycled composite material. And I'm going to fill it up and I'm going to pull it all out and it's going to be stuck at zero again. That way I don't have little residual amounts left over. It's pretty easy to figure out how much I'm going to make on every mission. And I only pull one thing at a time. You can do that. You can pull multiple things at a time if you want, but that's how I do it. It just makes it easy for me. Okay, and then on my ship, let's see. I like to keep a change of clothes because I don't always like to be in light armor when I go out and do this. Sometimes I just wear my civvies and go out. Oh, I need this. I carry an SRT on board the Vulture at all times because sometimes I just go out and fill up the canister from one of the wrecks I find. That way I have a backup for making doing bondo work and stuff on my ships, repair work. I carry one of the large tractor beams, the max lift tractor beams, because I find ships all the time that are upside down or whatever, and then when I find them on planets, I like to flip them over. If the engine's dead, you're gonna need this tractor beam. So if you flip it over, you can get the other side of the recycled composite material off of it. I bring some food. I always make sure I have drinks aboard because scraping is hard work. I have a shotgun at all times with some ammo for it, because this is my door opener. If I need to get in a ship that has the shields on still that I'm going to scrap, I use this and it pops the door right open. I found an 890 jump last night. I used that to get in. I went inside, turned off the shields and everything, and I ended up getting 36 or 37, I think it was 37 SKU off of it on the just recycled composite material last night. So I didn't crack it because obviously the vulture is not going to crack a 890 jump, but hey, I got all that recycled material off it. It was a found ship, so it didn't cost me anything. But some people don't like to do scraping. I like scraping, but I do it differently because I do take those missions to go get rid. I take the illegal salvage missions. So if you go in your personal salvage, I take these Drake Cutlass missions, and they also have the Constellation Andromeda missions, which pay you 80,000 credits plus bonuses. When I go out there, I tend to take like 2 or 3 SKU of recycled composite material off of them, and then I pop them and leave, and I don't pick up any of the construction material. And I know I'm going to be doing like 10 or 15 or 20 of those contracts, and by the time I get done doing my run of contracts, if you do 20 of them, that's like 1.6 million credits right there. And you can do them really fast. But it'll fill up your hopper after you do like 7 of them. So you go down, you empty your hopper, it's all empty again. You go out and do 7 more, that's 14, you know. And then by the time you get 20 of them done, you have 3 loads out of your hopper, 3 full loads. So you got 2 loads down on the cargo grid and 1 full load in the hopper, and you got all that to sell plus all the missions you did. And it's only 1 material. And you're not spending all the time in the world out there just scraping away at one ship, because when you get to the ship first, that material is going to come off much faster than when it's getting lower. So when you get out there and it's got 100% of the material aboard on the hull, when you pull it, it's going to pull at a faster rate than when the material has diminished. But we have to go over to Yella, and that's why I base myself here out of Crusader, because all the missions I do are going to be in the rings of Yella, and I'm just going to stick around Yella and keep popping and pulling these missions until I make enough money. And in fact, I'm only making 1.1 million on this trip here just to get the 7 million. It's not going to take very long at all. You can literally do these missions in 30 seconds. Do each one back to back to back to back to back. If you don't do any scraping and just want the 80,000 credits, I like to do the scraping because it's just bonus money. And I only spend like a minute or two doing the scraping anyway per ship. But if you wanted to, you don't have to do any scraping, or you can just pick up the construction materials after you have popped the ship. Okay, we are a Yella, and there's our target right there. Okay, here's another tip. Every time I'm jumping into an asteroid field, I make sure I am not moving. I have 0 airspeed and my cruise control's off, because a lot of the times you're gonna pop out in the asteroid field, either right in front of an asteroid or even inside of an asteroid. And if you are moving, you will explode. So I like to get in there and just stop, rotate around, take a look around, make sure I'm not inside a huge asteroid. Sometimes that happens, and sometimes you'll just kind of see it. Like I could pop in, see that one right below me there, that big one. Sometimes you'll pop in, you'll be right inside that one, and you have to creep out really slow at like 8 meters per second to get out of there without exploding. And eventually you'll come out the surface of the asteroid without any damage. But if you move too fast, you will explode. Your ship will register a ton of damage, and you're done. You'd be going back home. I should have set my spawn at Orson, but Even though I can kind of see here, see all the ash rates, I always just ping anyway. Just because there may be a small tiny one out there in the blackness you don't see. And if you hit it, it will kill you. So I'm going to turn the headlights on. The headlights finally work on the Vulture. That's wonderful. Always keep the sun to my back so I can see. Do not engage your tractor beam on these missions because you will get a crime stat. It is considered illegal towing. So you always just want to use your scrapers and not the right click on the mouse button to change the module that you're using to the tractor beam and the A-Brid. But see how much material is already coming off? We already got a half a skew. I tend to get just like 2 skew per ship and go pop it and leave. So we'll see how long this takes to do each ship. And like I said, you don't have to pull this material off. If you don't want it, you can just pop the ship, get the 80,000 credits and keep rolling. I prefer to do it this way because I feel like I'm actually salvaging. But you don't have to on this mission. Same thing goes for the non-illegal missions. You can just pop them and get out of there. But it's a salvage ship, man. You're supposed to be like literally salvaging. Plus the recycled composite material sells for like 16,000 credits per SKU. So I look at it, it's an extra 30,000 credits every time I grab 2 SKU off each ship. So times that by 20, I'm gonna do 20 of these missions. Usually that's an extra 600,000 credits, you know, that I would have just left there. And literally this takes, I only been here like 2 minutes now and I'm already at my 2 SKU limit I set myself per ship. And once I hit that 2 SKU, I'm gonna turn off the beams, I'm gonna turn on the muncher, I'm gonna munch the ship, and then I take off. I'm not even gonna pull the construction material off of it. I don't care about the construction material. It's not really worth it. It's super easy to get, but I'm literally just going for the RMC and the 80,000 credits. All right, so we're at 2 SKU. You don't know, it's right down there where it says depot. We're gonna switch over, which is Alt W, which turns on the fracture beam. We're gonna fracture it right up. So hit left mouse click activates the fracturing procedure. If you line up your crosshair right there where that little circle is forming in the middle, that's the quickest way to fracture it. As soon as it fractures, I back off, I hit M to retract my arms and shut off the fracturing beam. And there we go, I got 80,000 credits right there plus the 2 SKU. And now I'm gonna go open my contract manager and go to the next, go to the next mission. Drake Cutlass Black cleanup. Bam, bam, bam. We got another one. Gonna do the same thing. Make sure I'm not moving before I jump to the marker. Cruise control is off. I have no forward momentum. Bam, bam. And I'm there. Once again, look around. Before you start moving, just make sure you're not inside of an asteroid. There you go. And then ping. Pretty safe here. And like when you get to the ship, when you first get to the ship, that material is going to pull off so fast. Look at it. It's coming at 4 micro SCU per second. I don't know if it's micro. Yeah, it's micro. Or is it mini? It's mini. So, we're going to fill up that another 2 SKU really fast. Instead of sitting here and trying to get every little piece of the hull material off, we're just going to grab 2 and go pop it and get out of here. This is what I like to do. You can do it any way you want. You can come in here, not take any of the material off, just pop it and go. Or you can pop it and just take the construction materials. But then you're going to be limited to the lower valued construction material in your hopper. Where I'd rather have 3 hoppers full of RCM than construction material, because I know I can fit 24 or 25 skew inside my cargo area. Even though I only have a grid for 12, I can fit double that. And then I can keep the hopper full too. So I may have like 37, 38 skew worth of construction material by the time I go to sell it. I may have to come back to the ship and unload the hopper again after I saw my initial full load. And that way you're only taking one type of material, and when you empty out the hopper and you empty out your cargo area, when it's all full and it's all back to zero again and ready to go next time you go out. All right, we're at 4 skew. We're gonna hit Alt W, turn on the fracturing beam. We're gonna line our crosshair up right there where that circle is, get as close as we can. Look how fast it's moving in. As soon as it pops, we're gonna back up and retract our beams by hitting M, or our arms, so they don't break off. They have made the Vulture more resilient to the arms not breaking off, but it can still happen. Looks like someone might have already been here pulling material off of this one. They might have found it while they're out here on a mission or doing a different. I'm just gonna grab what I can, but it looks pretty picked over already. And I highlight a piece and it's telling me there's only 10% material on it. Or the game could have just spawned it in like that. But when I'm out here doing these missions, I do come across other ships that are probably parts of other people's salvage missions. And I'll take them if I see them. Coming to 323, I don't know how this stuff's going to work, because they are kind of resetting the economy. Missions are going to, contracts and everything are going to pay differently. Ships are going to cost more in game and with real life money too. They're going to change all the prices on things. Not everything's going to cost more. Some things may cost less, but they are adjusting it to some kind of standard that they've thought of. I'm not really sure. We'll see how it goes. I'm hoping we'll start getting on the road to a real player driven economy here, and we don't have any more of this, those ridiculous missions that just give you countless millions way too easily. There should be no missions that you make millions off of. But if you can do these salvage missions and make a million, you know, like a day or whatever, you know, I could see that being pretty normal. I can see running whole seas and making like a million an hour. But yeah. All right, so this one is pretty much out of material, so I'm just gonna kind of stop trying to pull material off of it, because I'm not really getting anything. We're just gonna pop it and go. We'll make up the 0.8 skew that we didn't get on the next ship. I find moving the beam around a little faster than just letting it sit there actually increases your skew rate that you're pulling it with. Because you're just like grabbing that top material super fast. That comes off really fast and easily. And then once that rate starts to slow down is when I'll just kind of let my scraper beams just sit there and soak it up. If you are doing this and your scraper heads, the modules, are consistently telling you there's 0.0 and it still looks like it's pulling material, you can't pull any kind of throughput or material, and your hopper's not getting any fuller, you have a bug that is common with the Vulture, and there's honestly no way to fix it other than claiming a new Vulture. So that's usually when I will take it over to not PO over there at Seraphim, and I'll transfer all my stuff that I have aboard the ship. And if I have cargo aboard, I'll sell it all either at Orison or at PO, or not PO, but Seraphim. And depending on what it is, because at Seraphim you can sell the construction material, and at PO you can sell the recycled composite material and the construction material. But make sure you sell all your cargo first, empty out your hopper, transfer all your stuff you have in inventory over to another inventory or into a box and take it with you so you can put it on the new vulture. Take the vulture outside one of the pads. Don't leave it on the pad, but leave it outside the pad and ditch it. Go inside, claim a new ship. Stop leaving your ships on pads and logging out and stuff, because that causes people who need to rearm and refuel to be unable to. Otherwise, you know, people like to just stop and go, but people are leaving their ships on there regularly, and it's really, well, the whole community is kind of frustrated about it. So just be kind, be aware. If you are going to leave your stuff there for whatever reason, don't be a jerk. Leave your stuff unlocked and open with the shields off, so that way someone in an SRV or something can come along and just take it away. Or even a salvage ship can come and salvage it. But just leaving it there on the pads causes all kinds of disruptions for players, and it's not appreciated. Not in any shape, way, shape, or form. All right, we're about to be full here in the hopper, and I'm going to go down and pull all the boxes. And you'll see that because I only pulled one type of material, I'm going to be able to pull every single bit of material out of the hopper. It's full. See, look at that. It's taking one SKU out now, and it's going to be 12 left. We're just going to stack them up here. I'm going to start stacking them so I can fill this thing up to the brim. So I'm going to do three rows, three columns, stacked two high. And I'm going to start that right from the beginning. I'm going to fill up this whole back, even off here, off the grid. So I should have six per row. So by the time I fill up those three rows, I'll have 18, and then I can put six more on the ground here. I just lift things up gently with the multi-tool, and I place them down gently, and there's usually no problem. You slam it in there and you're bouncing it around off everything, you're gonna have a problem. All right, as you can see, there's no material in there. We got 13 SKU on the floor. We can get another 11 on the floor. Maybe 12. I usually go for 11. 24 is usually good. And then you can put another 13. So that's 37 SKU total of RMC you can have on the ship. No reason to go flying into here, moving, you know, super fast. Keep it around 300 or less. It'll give you plenty of time to slam on the brakes if you need to, or even thrust away into a different direction before you hit something. You know, 300 meters per second, I think like over 500 miles per hour. So you are moving pretty quickly. And that's it, man. You just rinse and repeat this until you are full. Empty out your hopper again for the second time when it gets to 11 SKU, and then just keep doing these 80,000 credit missions until you are satisfied with how much money you made. You need 20 of them, you know, that's 1.6 million plus bonus with all the SKU you'll have aboard of RMC, or you can just pop them and take the 1.6 million. But if you take the RMC with it, three loads should net you another 500,000 maybe. So you're looking at over 2 million to do this. It's not that hard. Really fast. You could do that easily every day if you got like an hour and a half to kill. All right, so the hopper's full. Well, it's not full. It's got 11 SKU in it, and that's exactly what I need to fill up the rest of the cargo area. So I'm going to go empty that out, and then I can refill up the hopper, or the buffer, whatever people want to call it. I call it the hopper. I don't know why. I just do. That's what it reminds me of. So yeah, we're going to get 11 of them right here on this grid. And like I said, if you put them down gently, you should have nothing to worry about. Come in.
There we go.
They have to hit continue. There we go. We should be able to get two more. I'm going to pick this last one up straight up and hold it there until the other one comes down. Look at that. Now the hopper's empty again, right? Oh, it's got 0.1 in there. Whatever. I can fill it up. I could actually probably have gotten one more right there, but whatever. I'm not even going to worry about
that's
it.
That's 24 skew down in the cargo hold.
We're going to check what my total is right now, because I think I'm pretty dang close to the 7 million I was shooting for. 6.6 with what we have in the hold. All right, I'll do two more. I'm not going to fill up the cargo hold again, because I don't have all the time in the world today, but I've been out about an hour. So I will have made just about a million credits once I sell everything. All right, we're at about 6.8. And then with what I have aboard to sell, I'll be over 7 million. I'm heading back to Crusader to sell my cargo. And I leave my Vulture at Crusader or at Seraphim. And I always work out here. We are down. We are safe. We have a ship full of RMC. I lived. Nobody attacked me. It's a pretty good day. Can't complain. And we're gonna have 7 million once we sell everything. All right, we're at 7.12 million. Plus I have like three more skew, I think, in the hopper. Two or three more skew in the hopper that I picked up on the last ship I popped. Not bad. 7.1, I'll probably have like 7.15 after I saw what's in the hopper. So not a bad day. I don't know what to do with my money. I don't know what we're doing for 323, if they're doing any kind of wipe or anything. They have not said. They said a couple months, I think it was like a month ago, that they were discussing possibly doing a monetary wipe for 323. Who knows? I suspect they might do full complete wipe, everything. Like wipe, rep, wipe, everything. Who knows? We'll see. Everything basically is being fundamentally changed and reset for the next patch. So I could see them wiping everything, or I could just see them saying, you know what, screw it, we're gonna wipe it 4.0, or maybe even just go to beta. Who knows? We'll see. It's Star Citizen. It's Alpha. None of this matters. That's it, man. Thanks for joining me. Thanks for hanging out. Got any questions about Vulture tips or anything, drop them down below. I'll try and answer them. If not, maybe some of the community will have an answer for you. Like I said, this is just how I do it. You may do it differently.
take it just as advice. That, you know, what I say is not like golden rule, like, hey, you can't do it any other way, do it this way or that way. Just, it's just more knowledge, man. Knowledge is power. And you guys will be well on your way to making a fortune as a stripper. Strippers get paid well. You didn't know. Anyway, I will see you guys later. I'll give you a salute and then I'm out of here. If you have not so yet, please hit the subscribe button. You can also become a channel member if you wish to go above and beyond helping out the channel here. That's for you guys. I love you all and I'm out. Catch you guys later. Peace.